Hi, Stacy Campbell here of Shiloh Global, and I am here with Rick Taylor of the Healing Rooms of the Santa Maria Valley, which is the home of Shiloh Global. And I actually have my little Healing Rooms shirt on, so I'm totally dressed for the occasion. But we have been hearing a lot about what the Spirit is saying, you know, geographically to this region, to the Healing Rooms, but even as a prototype and a model of what God is doing on the earth in this new era. And we have some exceptionally exciting testimonies today, but this is Rick Taylor, who is the founder and leader of the Healing Rooms of the Santa Maria Valley. It's an apostolic center, many ministries. Like, give us a little rundown of what the Healing Rooms is.
Well, we started out as just healing rooms, you know, praying for the sick. And the Lord really started really blessing us in the area of miracles. And people started coming from all over. That's about 21 years ago. And we started really small, and it grew because for whatever reason, God had favor with us. And we just had a real breakthrough with people coming from all over. And receiving healing.
You know, you said for whatever reason. Well, yesterday I was with you, and we had leaders from that are speakers at the UN and that are heads. She was a lawyer, but very prophetic. And she said, you know, I travel all over the world. I'm with all kinds of people. And she says, what I see over you and Lori is this incredible humility. I've not seen it like this anywhere else. So for the whatever reason is kind of like Moses. Moses, the Bible says, was the meekest man, the most humble man on the face of the earth. And that's why he could handle power. And I think humility and power go hand in hand, because when pride comes, you get manipulation, you get control, but when you have humility handling great power and great miracles, then the glory goes to God, you know? So it's beautiful. But I just had to say that because I was there and I heard that prophetic word. But anyway, so we're in a series of what the Spirit is saying to the church. And we have had a plethora of speakers discussing different things that the Lord's saying, because you know, it is, God is so big that one person doesn't hold the corner on truth, you know, or understanding, and one gift doesn't hold the corner on truth. And really, God has been speaking very powerfully to this ministry and to the region about creating a prototype for what is to come. And what are you seeing God do, and what are you hearing God say?
Yeah. Well, what I'm hearing God saying now, and again, let me back up. We shut down during COVID, we know, but we didn't shut down. We just for walk-in, but we did a lot. Every day we're doing online, live, you know, ministry, healing, prophecy. We were doing teachings and seminars, you know, over Zoom. So we didn't we didn't stop.
Right, and that's still going on. So that is still going on. If people want to actually avail themselves of the ministry of the Healing Rooms, you can go to healingroomssmv.com, or you can go to the Healing Rooms of the Santa Maria Valley Facebook page, and you can sign up for healing prayer, prophetic prayer. It's still going on, but keep going.
Yeah, and so we shut down as far as walk-ins. We reopened in March, but the Lord said, we're in a new era. Don't do it like you were doing. Change up the ministry. Mm-hmm. And we had every day we would have a service with speaking, and we had some good, some great services. But the Lord said, you know, this is all about worship now and hosting my presence. And so Monday night, we have a regular service with teaching. But the rest of the week, we're devoted just to hosting the presence of God. And just worshiping the Lord. Mm-hmm. And I'll tell you something, his presence is coming so wonderfully strong, and people are encountering Jesus and being healed just in worship and being in the atmosphere. And the Lord told me that if we host his presence, everything would come out of that. All ministry would come out of that, you know, because we have multiple ministries. We have, gosh, we probably have 16 to 20 ministries. I lost count of how many ministries happen in this apostolic center. But the worship and the prayer times we have is the fuel, the furnace that just causes everything else just to happen. You know,
it is phenomenal, because when you host the presence, when it's kind of like heaven on earth. In heaven, Jesus is the center of everything.
Yeah.
And when you do on earth what you see in heaven, then you get heavenly results. And what are we seeing happening just out of hosting the presence in the middle of worship?
We're seeing so much. I'm just, you know, this week, you know, we had a man that came in and he had a bad back and he was battling depression and even battling taking his life.
Wow.
And during worship, the power of God hits him and his back is healed. And that spirit of depression left him. And
wow.
He gave testimony of that with nobody ministering to him. You know, it was
sovereign.
Just the presence of the Lord. It was really, it's just amazing. And then we've also saw, you know, someone get healed this week, Parkinson's disease, a severe case where he would shake, you know, couldn't stop shaking, pain all through his body, couldn't walk without assistance, had to quit playing in the band he was playing. He was a violinist, and God heals this man, and he's completely healed. Not just partially, but he's 100% healed. Every symptom is gone, and he called his band back up. Hey, I'm back on the team, you know, in the band, and it's just an amazing thing. It's things that doctors can't do.
Mm-hmm.
But when we host the presence, God can do it. And we like to say it like this, you know, when the healer's in the house, miracles happen
yeah.
automatically. Our goal is to have people come and encounter Jesus, to see Jesus, to feel him. And when they feel his presence, we say, just go one step further, reach out and touch him.
Wow.
Because the Bible tells us everyone who touched Jesus was
right.
healed. And so when we host his presence, healings, miracles, signs and wonders, all these things just are a byproduct of his presence.
That's amazing. And I love how you honor and desire and long for the presence of God.
Mm-hmm.
But this doesn't just, you don't just have to be in the room. You were saying that during COVID, you continued to pray for the sick.
Yes.
You continued to have prophecy
yes.
teams. And people started logging in from all over the world.
Yeah.
Tell us what some of the testimonies from that.
Well, we've had people, you know, that used to come and fly in from other countries and stuff like that. That was pretty normal. But when we shut down for walk-ins and we advertised online that we're ministering to those who need a touch from the Lord, we all of a sudden the world got a hold of it, and miracles just started happening worldwide, and our teams have just a list of people giving their lives to the Lord, people coming out of depression, coming out of suicide,
praying online,
yeah.
only say the word, not yeah. even laying hands on them, not yeah. even being in the room, but online, just calling out and praying,
yeah.
and they're getting healed in Japan, in Africa. They're getting healed all over the world.
All over the world.
Mm-hmm.
And people being healed of cancer. People are being healed of arthritis and migraines, crippling diseases, you know. They're being healed, you
mm-hmm.
know. And it's a divine connection. But I think it's all about, you know, again, hosting this presence. And, you know, his presence isn't limited to one place. I think we are carriers of his presence.
Mm-hmm.
When we're in his presence goes with us, and then we can release his presence,
mm-hmm.
even through ministry, even as we're ministering, you know, through Zoom, you know, that presence still is so powerful. It could go through that screen and touch the person that's being ministered to.
Wow. Now, Rick, I know because this is the home where we live, and it's the home of our
mm-hmm.
ministry. But we're part of your apostolic center. But I've seen people fly after COVID because they got ministered to online from, was it Japan, different places. And what happened to that person that actually testified from Japan?
Well, this woman came from Japan, and again, she had a multiple things she got healed of. But one of the main things is she had cancer, and she went through radiation, which affected her eye. She really couldn't see well, and she had to wear dark glasses, even inside,
mm-hmm.
even in a building, because it was too intense. Even a small light would affect her eyes and would hurt her eyes. But just during worship, just during the worship time, the presence of God came on her, And she felt something going on in her eye. She takes off her sunglasses because she always had to wear sunglasses, even in dark places, always had to wear sunglasses. And she looked, and all of a sudden, everything was normal, and there was no more pain. She walks outside, and she's looking in the bright sun, and she was completely, wonderfully restored and healed.
Wow, I know. I heard her give that testimony, and she's like, and she's looking at a bright light just like that, and she's good. I can see. I couldn't look at the light before. And it was really amazing, because when people get touched by the presence of God, it doesn't just affect them physically. It affects their soul, their spirit. Mm. It's a touch of the love of God, you know. Yeah. It's a beautiful, beautiful thing. So, Rick, what would you say that the Lord has been speaking? What is the Spirit saying to the church about healing and about the miraculous right now?
Well, it goes right back to hosting his presence, you know, and making it all about worshiping the Lord. I remember Paul Kane, before he passed away, he was a part of the ministry, but he was having dinner with us, and it was a confirmation to me, but he said, Rick, this next move of God is gonna come, this next revival is gonna come out of worship. And I go, man, that was exactly, it was such a confirmation, because God was telling me that. And so we're going after with everything. It's but by design, mm-hmm. what can we do just to host his presence? Not mm-hmm. make it about us, not make it about our program, but make it about Jesus, make it about God, make it about his program, following the lead of the Holy Spirit. You know, and it's so often we have our plans and we have our goals and our agendas. But the Lord said, just lay that all aside, just worship me. And out of that, I'm going to show you what I'm about to do. And so that's what we're doing. We're hosting his presence. And there's not a day goes by where people don't come and say, man, I just can't believe the thick presence of God in this place.
It's true.
Even people that minister and go all over the world, you know, and minister in all different types of settings, they come here and they're just like overwhelmed by the presence of the Lord.
Yes, the lady yesterday that works a lot in the Middle East, she was just saying that same thing. And, you know, really, it's what you're saying. You never deviate from what the Spirit is saying to us as a ministry, to the healing rooms, is that this is the great reset.
Yes.
This is the reset for the whole church. It's not about the programs, although programs come out of the presence.
Yes.
It's not about the miracles, although great miracles are coming out of the presence. It's not, it's really, the reset is the first commandment in first place. You know, as we love the Lord our God with all our heart, soul, strength, and mind, God invades our life doing what only God can do.
Yeah.
And so this is the great reset of the new era. And what would you say to listeners watching? Because I know that part of the prophetic words over here is like miracles, so great. And we're already seeing the trickle of that. But I think there's going to be an explosion of the miraculous. But even the miraculous can become a detractor to the first commandment. We look at his hands and not his face, as it were, you know. So what would you say to any listeners listening right now, what they need to do to get ready?
Well, I think there's a great distraction in ministry because there's so much to do. Mm-hmm. And, you know, in Isaiah 66, 1, it says, this is what the Lord says. Heaven is my throne. Earth is my footstool. Where is the house you'll build for me? Mm-hmm. Where will my resting place be? Mm-hmm. And I'm in that place. All I want is to build a house for the Lord, you know, a resting place, a habitation of his glory, where people can come in and experience him. Mm-hmm. Not our programs, you know, not our everything we have to offer with our talent and our mm-hmm. giftings. You know, I mean, none of that matters anymore. Mm-hmm. All we're looking is people to encounter him. And if we can do that, you know, we're accomplishing, and I believe, what God asks us to do. And so there's nothing greater, there's nothing more fulfilling than being in the presence of the Lord. Mm-hmm. The people that came, you know, yesterday, they just said, you know, we want to move here. We want to buy real estate here just to be in the presence. Mm-hmm. And they were talking about the open heaven, the portal that is here, but it's here by design. Mm-hmm. You know, God's ways are higher than our ways. His thoughts are higher than ours. Now, he lets us have our way. He lets us have our ideas. But when we refer to him, or prefer to him,
yeah.
and just say, this is your way, lead us, Holy Spirit, mm-hmm. you know, and then he just, it's his house.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so when we come, I like to say it like this, when we come into the Healing Rooms Apostolic Center, we don't have to invite him to come. He's okay. already here. We're coming into his house. And he's always here. We had a couple of ladies came over Christmas, didn't realize we're closed. Mm-hmm. And they came, they drove a long distance to come to be here to receive healing prayer. And they get to the get to the healing rooms and they pulled on the door and they realized it was locked. And but when they touched the door, they both grabbed the handle. They were going to open it, but the power of God shot through them and they both got healed.
Wow.
Now, we weren't here. We were gone, but we built him a house.
Right.
See, the Lord was here. We built a resting place, a habitation of, wow. of his presence. So, you know, it's not about us. It's not about our gifting. It's not about our talent. It's not about our education. You know, it's all about hosting the
yeah.
presence, the
wow.
presence of the healer.
Can you pray then? And I think this is... really, that's the heart of David. You know, David's heart was to build God a resting place.
Yeah.
And he built him a tabernacle in his lifetime and stored up to build him a temple in, you know, in his son's lifetime. That to this very day, Jews go to that place and touch the rock, and people from all over the world go, just touch the rocks of the place where, you know, God physically dwelt. And he... where people host his presence, he just comes.
Yeah.
And his spirit is there and he stays there,
yeah.
you know. And so can you pray for people, their eyes to be open, and that wherever they are, they would create a little resting place
yeah.
for God in their homes, in their businesses, wherever
Absolutely.
God's called them. Can you pray for
Absolutely.
Everybody watching right now?
Yeah. And again, I just want to just say this real quick. Again, doing good things, doing the kingdom stuff, we can get distracted.
It's true.
And but when we host his presence, I don't even bring my cell phone into the meetings.
Mm.
I want no distraction.
Mm.
I just want to focus on him. And you know, when we give him that time and mm. just soak in his presence,
mm-hmm.
he gives us so much revelation.
That's true.
And he charged, it's like when we plug our cell phones into the power.
Right.
It charges it up. And,
right.
and there's so much communication, there's so much revelation that comes through that. And we need that, especially those of us who are in ministry that are giving all the time.
Mm-hmm.
We need to get filled back in. We need to plug in to the
exactly.
power source. And it's his presence that does that.
Yeah.
And so we spend time, as you know, here at the Healing Room, we just soak in his presence.
Mm-hmm.
And then...
hours a day. Every yeah. morning we start with that. 9:30, at least 10:30, sometimes 11:30. It just... however long, that's yeah. our start where the whole community comes. Yeah.
We got to start full.
Mm-hmm.
That's why we don't start any ministries until we've been mm-hmm. in his presence.
Wow.
And in worship and mm-hmm. In his presence. And then we go into our ministries. And that's what makes the ministry successful.
Mm-hmm.
It's hard to go in cold turkey and expect results.
Mm-hmm.
It becomes mechanical.
It's true.
You know, and it becomes practicing religion and religious things.
Instead of relationships.
And, yeah, instead of carrying the presence mm-hmm. we were just in, releasing that power to those who are coming to receive.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
wow.
So it's all about that.
This is a massive reset, and I'm sure there are people, you are listening to this, and your own heart is getting convicted. You know, I've gotten distracted along the way. I've gotten busy along the way, but this is part of the new era, getting the first commandment again back in first place, finding the presence of God every single day, no matter what you're doing. And I would speak even to the prophetic people out there that all of the prophets, their primary ministry was to the Lord. They never stopped doing that. The reason they received so much revelation, as you said, was they spent time every day in God's presence. Moses did it. Daniel did it. David did it. Jesus did it. The disciples did it. They never stopped going to the temple for the hour of prayer. They set their face towards Jerusalem. Daniel did, even when he was in Babylon and distracted. And this is a key to everything in the kingdom of God, that the King of the kingdom is the center. So please pray.
Yeah. Lord, I just want to first thank you for your presence. Lord, thank you for what comes out of your presence. Lord, the glory, the manifest presence of God comes, Lord, when you're here, when we make a way for you, Lord. And Lord, I just pray, Lord, right now that people would begin to understand that. And Lord, would you give them grace to make that a priority? Mm-hmm. And Lord, I know as we do that, Lord, your promises always is, I'm going to take you to a new level. And Lord, we thank you, Lord, for the open heaven that we have over this place. And Lord, it only happened through obedience. We couldn't create it on our own. We all want it. We couldn't work for it. We couldn't do enough for it in practicing things, religious things. But Lord, we just allowed you to guide us and to show us, Lord, the things that are important to you in this new era. And it's all, everything comes out of your presence. And so, Lord, I'm so humbled and I'm so grateful, Lord, for what you're doing here at the Healing Rooms Apostolic Center here in Santa Maria. And Lord, I'm asking what you're doing here, will you do it all over the world?
Yes.
Lord, would you impart to those who are watching? Lord, would you impart to ministries and ministers and pastors? Lord, prophets and apostles? Lord, would you just release from here to them an impartation of showing them how just to host your presence, to be still and to know that you're God. And Lord, we know as we make that a priority, everything gets done that needs to be done without us striving to do it. And so Lord, release your presence. Lord, you said to pray, my kingdom come, my will be done on earth as it is in heaven. What does it look like in an open heaven? What does it look like when your kingdom comes? Mm-hmm. We can't have a kingdom without a king. And Lord, we thank you that you're the King of the kingdom. And Lord, you, when you're here, Lord, your kingdom follows. And so Lord, I just bless those, Lord, that are watching and listening, mm-hmm. Lord, that they would begin to encounter you. I pray even right now, Lord, just begin to release that presence I'm talking about. We're in the building right now. And Lord, we're carrying it right now. Would you just begin to release the manifest presence of your glory that brings amazing peace. I just release that and I pray that in Jesus' name.
Amen. 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 And if you want to actually come and watch some of the programs of the Healing Rooms, you can go to healingroomssmv.com. Join in. It's free. You can log on to the worship sets and, you know, Monday to Thursday. And also, if you want to see this program and others like it, you can download my free Shiloh Global app. Watch all these things, what the Spirit is saying, and let's get aligned with the King of the kingdom to just follow the Lamb wherever he goes right now. So you can check all those things out and just get yourself into the presence of God every single day. So bless you.
Thank you, everyone, for listening to the Shiloh Global Podcast. We hope you've enjoyed this episode, and if you'd like to help us continue to make these great programs, we encourage you to donate at our website, wesleystacycampbell.com. Also, check out Stacy Campbell's Shiloh Company Prophetic Mentorship, where you can be mentored in the prophetic by Stacy herself. Download our free Shiloh Global app, available on the Apple App Store and Google Play Store. On the app, you can hear more programs not listed on the Charisma Podcast Network. And finally, if you enjoyed today's episode, please subscribe, rate, and review the show on iTunes, the Charisma Podcast Network, or wherever you listen to podcasts.